Hey, hello guys. Would you like to learn how to design these awesome gradient wallpapers that I'm gonna put in the screen right now?
Just stay in this video, because I'm gonna teach you how.
Okay guys, the first thing that we're gonna do is create a document in Adobe Illustrator. In my case, I did it in 5,120 pixels by 280 pixels, which is the resolution of my iMac, so I can use it as a wallpaper. I'm gonna put this document in the description below with the colors that I use for this particular wallpaper so you can follow along. The first step will be to create a square, roughly the size of the artboard. And let's take the first color, which is like a cream white, like a bluish cream white. And then we're gonna select the option of the mesh tool. With this mesh tool, what we're gonna do is create some dots, some spots right here, and we're gonna start copying the colors. I'm gonna do with the dark color right here, and I'm gonna try to mesh this color, make it, you know, a little bit more chaotic. Something like this will work really well. And then we're just gonna take it like this. I wanna stretch it. Okay, and then we're gonna add another node right underneath it, like right here. And this one is gonna have purple color. Once we select the nodes, we can actually change the properties of them. And this is really useful to create the type of bending that I like to do for the gradient itself. So what I like to do is just try to make them clash a little, but without creating too much friction within the gradient. I'm just trying to avoid those harsh corners that are created right there. Let me try to zoom a little bit more so you can see it better. So I'm gonna try to reduce this. Something like this will be fine. And then if I stretch it all the way here, just trying to make it as less rough as possible at the edges. Okay, this is looking good. I'm gonna add another node right here at the top on top of this. And this one should be a little bit of a reddish color. I think that'll be really helpful. And in this color right now, what I'm gonna do is keep editing it in a way that I make it dominate the other colors. And this could be really cool if I do it this way. Okay, I'm gonna stretch it a little bit more to the side. The idea of this is doesn't have to be so perfect, because at the end of the day, what makes it look cool is how abstract it can end up being. So don't be too hard when you're trying to do it to make it so perfect. Like, don't be too hard to yourself when you're trying to do it and it's not perfect. So the trick most of the times is just to try to do whatever you feel like it will look the best. So I think this area right here, I can stretch this to the other side so it looks, oh, that's looking better right there. And I'm gonna add a lighter color right here on top of this. I can blend them with the other colors and it looks less rough in that particular spot. There we go. I don't want to blend it like that. I want to take this color right here, stretch it out like that. I would like to also take this green that I have right here and create another node right here. This one, I want to create it like right here. And this one should be an even lighter color like this one that I have right here. And then after I do this clash with the colors, I think I should start mixing them a little bit more right in this top area, like adding more of the purple color and then just extending it through the gradient, like something like that. This could be really cool. But in between these two, I think I should put something more like a, okay, like that color. That could work. Let me move this around. Yeah, the idea is to mix the colors without being too intrusive with them. And I ended up with something like this. Don't worry about it. This is not gonna be the final result of this. This is gonna be just our starting point. The next step will be to take this smart object or vector object to Photoshop. I'm gonna open Photoshop right now. I'm gonna create a new file. And this is gonna be 5,120 by 280. We're gonna name it wallpaper gradient. We're gonna create a document. We're gonna have an empty document. I'm gonna go back to Adobe Illustrator. I'm gonna copy that. I'm gonna go to Photoshop. I'm gonna paste that. Here's when we're gonna have the good part of this, because we're gonna be able to distort and change the background in different ways that are gonna be really helpful to the final design. I'm gonna copy that as a smart object. We're gonna click OK. We're gonna have this great design right here. I'm gonna try to stretch it, find a crazy angle for it. It's gonna look really good if I put it like that. It has a little bit of an imperfection there, but it doesn't matter. We're gonna fix that one out with some great tricks. I'm gonna click OK. And then the first effect that I feel like we should add into this will be a blur. Let's create a Gaussian blur. And it's Gaussian blur. I think 4.5 could be good, but I don't like this edge that we have right there. So let me go back to Illustrator, because it's actually making it clash a little bit more than necessary. I think I need to fix it in here. Okay, and this needs to be fixed in here. Okay, and then we have this edge right here. I'm not trying to be perfect with this. I'm just trying not to have these rough, hard edges at the end of the design. So let me move this like this. Okay, I move this like reduce it all the way. Is it gonna go away? Okay, it's kind of a better way to approach this. Let me go back to Photoshop and let me paste it again. And let's just distort it a little just to move things away. If I press Command, I'm just gonna be able to distort a little bit the edges, get it a little bit away to the corner. And then I'm just trying to stretch it as much as possible. It's gonna be something like this, which is really good. The next step will be, again, going to the blur, Gaussian blur. And there in the Gaussian blur, we're gonna put to 4.5. pixels, the blur of the object. Let me try to tweak it a little bit more. I think 4.5 could be a little bit more, could be like 7.2. I think that will look better, or maybe a little bit less, like 5.2. After we add that Gaussian blur, we're gonna do some camera raw filters. We're gonna go to filter, and we're gonna click in camera raw filter. And there, I wanna play a little bit more with the curves of the image. So I'm gonna take the middle tones and I'm gonna boost them down a little. I'm gonna try to take the darks and put them a little bit higher, and then the lights a little bit lighter. Something like, should be like, let me take the darks a little bit darker. The middle tone right there. I'm gonna move in the lights a little bit here. The darks, I wanna just make them a little darker. The shadows a little bit more aggressive with the design, and then the highlights should be a little bit reduced, since at the end of the day, this is just like a wallpaper. And then the next step will be to apply some noise to the design, and it will be going to the selecting the design. We're gonna go to the filter, and we're gonna go to noise, and we're gonna add some noise. This noise should be something not that high. I would recommend something like a 4.5. and it will look really, really good. And I feel like the Gaussian blur should go a little bit higher because it doesn't look that blurry to me. So I will go with 28.9 or something like that, because I feel like with the noise, it complements a little better. So it's looking way better now. The next step that I would like to follow with this design would be to take the design again and create an adjustment layer. We're gonna create a new adjustment layer with hue and saturation. So the trick of this is boost the saturation like crazy. It's gonna look really bad, but I have a trick for this. We're gonna reduce the lightness and the saturation, and we're gonna leave it like that. And then selecting this layer, you see that you can select this one, this part of the adjustment layer, and you can select the mask. Okay, when we select the mask, what I like to do, I'm just gonna press Control or Command Option or Control Options. I'm gonna make the brush really big, and I'm gonna start dabbing in some part of the design so it's not that aggressive in all the tones. And I'm gonna just switch the colors here for white, so I can add more color to the next one. The next one thing that I would like to change here will be to add some levels to it. These levels, I'm gonna try to make them darker and boost the darks a little. And then something like this will be really good. So the next good thing with this, it could be that I can just select and start dabbing with the white color. So I can start making some spots lighter, some spots darker. I'm just trying to make it smaller and then try to make it light. And then going through the gradient, I can start just switching colors and start making some parts of it a little bit darker, like in the corners or the edges, just to add a little bit more dark. So another good thing that I would like to try is to duplicate that layer to create a little bit more like a darker edges. I'm gonna reduce the opacity, and I'm just gonna keep dabbing in some parts of the design. Okay, this is looking good. Let me try to do the next one. Okay, once I have this layers of adjustments, the next step will be to go with the last level of hue and saturation, and this just reduce the color like this. We're gonna go with the hue and saturation, and we're gonna reduce all the saturation, and then we're gonna take the brush again, and we're gonna start dabbing with bigger brush just to take the colors that we like from the design and start reducing a little bit of the darker colors. And we should end up with a design like this. And the next final step will be to create another layer. Sorry about that. And then I would like to put the feather like to 400 pixels. And then I make a selection of the artboard, which is gonna create this type of effect. And I press Command Shift I, where I can just press Option Delete. And then I can just fill out that layer again and again and again to create like this depth of field view, like at the around it. It's like a vignetting effect. And I will go with the multiply in this area. I'm gonna add some noise, some filter and some noise, and we're gonna add some noise to a little bit higher just to burn it in the edges. This is an optional part. It looks good without it. I will do it with 28.9, don't think, just to match the previous one that we have over there. We're gonna reduce a little bit of the opacity of this, and this will, it is an optional step. You can do it either like this, or you can just darken it like that, and you will have your awesome gradient. And this will bring us to the end of the video. But now is your turn. Are you planning to use these crazy wallpaper gradients in your next project? If so, just put it in the comments below. Also, if you feel like you learned something new with this video, just give it a like. That'll help me a lot. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you again in the next video.